into account. You've got to start the man who's in charge, and in charge here. Hold him up that. Here it comes, on the record. We're all in the same team. You've got your back, you have a very good relationship with Dr. Fauci. We're all in the same team. Good. Then listen to the doctor's orders. Let's stop this nonsense and figure out how can we get back control over this now. And looking forward, how can we ensure that next month we ought to have another example of California, Texas, Florida, and Arizona? Because those are the hot zones now, and I'm looking at the map. See, we've got to make sure it doesn't happen in other states. So rather than the games we can play, let's focus on that.
Now, that's what Trump should say. If you can't muster the message, at least listen to it and call off the dogs. Hold the group. How much BS would you come tomorrow? Did you hear what he was saying? He made a statement representing himself. He should be doing that. No, I have a very good relationship with Anthony.
I can't explain Peter Carroll. He's in the world by himself. So I don't even want to go there.
Fauci doesn't have to go. We need to go. Why? It's time to stand and be counted. We got big problems. Power needs all what they're doing and move to a better place. By power, I mean Trump. Come on. You know he's pretending he didn't know. And Navarro and others were doing. You know how that place works. He voted by one guy. Trump voted yesterday. A crowd of one. Time for the president to man up. You know your extra boys doing your dirty work. It's always the same. And civil rights is getting additional. If Navarro really wants going broke, they don't even know about it. Mr. You're fired. Where this signature accountability for someone going behind your back, breaking your rules, and attacking your foot who's on your team? What are you going to do? We're waiting. Now why we all hold our breath to that action? Fauci is left using his breath to comprehend all the others coming in.
Isn't it bizarre? I don't really fully understand it. You know, I think that what happened with that list that came out, I think if you sit down and talk to the people involved in that, they don't really, I can take it back. Why, what big mistake that was. I think that if you talk to these other people in the White House, they realize that was a major mistake on their part because it doesn't do anything but reflect poorly on them.
I think you're right. Let's look at the evidence of what's happened since the president doing his pratfall. I didn't know. These guys are all wrong. That happened a lot now, the president. People going out and going rogue. You see a lot of that. The vice president tweeting out this thing of Fauci sitting next to him earlier, calling it a productive meeting with the coronavirus task force. Hopefully it wasn't productive. And hopefully these spelled tactics have backfired enough to get out of twice before shifting lane and playing a BS game in the middle of a pandemic. Our kids' normalcy is on the line. Getting back to work is on the line. So let's get to where the energy should be. You want to talk about your response is a hoax. Where is the plan? Where is the testing guidance? Everybody who got through this did it with central plans. Okay, of course these things have power. But they need your help. They keep asking. They're asking now for help in schools. Are you helping? Are we any closer to being able to domestically source PPE in cases of R in the fall? Bring back manufacturing? Let's start with this. The pandemic is in full effect. It's feasting on us. Special red states and governors followed Trump's trail of denial to their own detriment. Now, why should you be hot? Why should you not believe? For the record. But more importantly, this. You tell me how a president in the middle of a pandemic has got time for this bullshit. Are you kidding? Hawking, trials, and boy, I'm paranoid. Resolute this. This is what he's resolute about. Pandemic priorities. His daughter, Ivanka, top White House advisor, argues, kidding. Marketing for a brand. Following calls for boycotts after Goya's CEO heaps praise on Trump last week. On your dime, in the middle of a pandemic, they're selling beans. Are you kidding me? Seriously. This is not left and right. This is reasonable, my brother. The guy's sitting on the principal desk with a bunch of FOIA fraud. Proof positive of why we need many vouchers, but we only have one. Why? The idea of him messing with Fauci when he's selling magic beans is crazy. What reason? That's the question. Now, he said none. Okay. So then what happens? Now things start to look more clear. Shift the blame. We'll stay on back. So we need. Cut out the CDC with data information. What's the good reason? Well, some hospitals were prepared. What does that have to do with the CDC being cut out? Make them report that. National Guard? Give us the data and the administration? Why? I don't know the good reason, but I know a bad one. Lie, deny, and defy. President, keep telling me the problem is testing. You don't think that has anything to do with his desire for this information? Wake up! This is what's making us sad. I do not want to see you people have to go through what I do. It never ends. It never ends, this thing, even a mild case. And look, you're going to keep seeing the desperation of the president is desperate, not about the pandemic, by himself. His latest news, Trump. Promoting his campaign manager, Brad Parsky. On one layer, that's what happens. Throws everybody else under the bus. That's a problem. The other, he's looking to get blame away from him. That's where his data is from. So keep an eye on him. Hold him to account. Make him do his damn job. But now let's talk about what that job should look like. So we have a frame of reference. Two top former public health officials. Former HHS Secretary Kathleen Sebelius. and former FDA Commissioner, Dr. Margaret Hamlin. Good to have you both. Sorry you had to listen to that, but, you know, sometimes in this business, I say what's coming so clearly that literally you get desperate about trying to get people to say, like, you're waving your hand. Here I come. Stop it. I'm coming. And I try to do what I can. First, Secretary Sebelius is still changing up a very honorable agency, important work. The idea of surpassing the CDC and having hospitals directly convey information, either to HHS or someone else in the administration, stinks to high heaven. To me, to you, what is your thing?
Chris, thanks for having me. It's great always to see my friend and colleague, Dr. Hamburg. I think it's a very bizarre decision. First of all, HHS is an umbrella agency. CDC is one of those agencies. The CDC in Atlanta is the Centers for Disease Control and Protection and the public health backbone of whatever database is at HHS. It's not open to the public, unlike the CDC database. So we are taking a step away from the public health agency and away from the public being able to see what the parents are and what's going on in the hospitals. If it's too slow or they're not getting the right data, then demand the right data. That is not high science. They've been doing this now for 6 months.
You know, if you don't like the process, then attack the process and create accountability. But shifting where it goes doesn't make sense. Dr. Harper, can you think of a good reason that they would be doing this? Maybe I'm missing something.
You know, I think it's a fundamental problem of not actually harnessing the capability and expertise that exists within an agency like the CDC. Maybe it's not working the way that it should be, but as you say, you address it, you help support it, you help to make sure that it's delivered. Creating a whole new system where it's going to have to harness.
Thanks.
Thanks.
You okay?
Yeah.
Keep sitting aside.
Hey, look. I'm missing cigarettes and trying to keep it calm.
Do you want to smoke your vape at all?
I kind of don't want that either. I don't really want that either. But I'm about to go have a cigarette.
The idea that Fauci is a bum who makes mistakes all the time and always has. He makes so many mistakes. He's gotten things wrong time and time. Have you ever heard that said about him? Did you ever witness with any kind of doubt or misgivings him in the line of people?
No, this is remarkable what's going on. It's so unfortunate and so reckless. Fauci is the kind of expert, scientist who understands public health, who has led this country and frankly the world through many other serious infectious disease problems. Any leader would have him at their side, helping to shape a response, helping to guide and answer questions. And, you know, it is extraordinary. It's just so unfortunate. He works night and day, and he's not doing it because he wants to be elected to something. He's not doing it for a huge paycheck. He's doing it because he cares, and he believes that by bringing scientific evidence and expertise to bear, that he can make a real difference. And we need him now more than ever.
Thank you very much for being with me. Who would imagine that a great scientist like Fauci, during a pandemic, would have to rely more on his instincts of being from Brooklyn than what he learned as a scientist just to make it through the administration he's working with right now? Unimaginable. But let's get back on the right track and keep people focused on where we need to go. We'll be right back at this.
Frizzy, unruly hair? You need a hair smoother. Get Frizzy Sleek and Shine in Moroccan Argan Oil. Hair is super sleek, even 97% humidity. No parabens. Frizzy Sleek and Shine by Garnier. Naturally. Guys, how frustrating is it to find a great fitting t-shirt? It's never the right length. Standard t-shirts are one size fits all. M-Tailor custom t-shirts use 8 different measurements to give you the perfect fit. Your phone can measure you right now. M-Tailor for iOS or Android.
This is Fracture. Just upload an image, place your order, and it'll show up at your door. Use the printing directly on glass. And this isn't just another print. This is Fracture. This is Fracture.com.
Kind of easy way to eat a facial consultation overnight.
Just take one more bag and the next morning
it's showtime! And I got this great flavor.
Instead of hot laxative gummies.
Easy to eat. Sorry.
heard about it a lot today. Don't let your best friend down. Get clinically proven joint flex with deep penetration for fast acting, long lasting relief. Flex your freedom with joint flex now at Turmeric.
Ta-da! Did you know Liberty Mutual customizes your car insurance so you only pay for what you need?
Given my unique lifestyle, that'd be perfect. Grab a pen and some paper. You know what? I'm gonna switch now. Just need my desk.
Jesus fuck.
My chair and my phone. Only pay for what you need.
Hospitalizations are going up with this new surge of cases. Forget about testing as the problem. That's just BS. Right? Look, I don't want to prove that. There's just no other way to get around it. The data shows, all right, the Trump administration doesn't want you to get it. That's why I say the response is with hoaxes. In a new word, hospitals are told to bypass the CDC by sending all their patient data to HHS in Washington. I have a former secretary of HHS with us. There is no good reason. HHS doesn't make this easier or better than having it go to the CDC. The chief of the America Public Health Association says this. The largest organization public health in New York. The disruption that HHS is going to create, the confusion, simply telling people to do something different in the middle of a disaster that does not work. It's like telling a soldier in the middle of a battle, we want you to fight differently than we train. Let's go back to the former Secretary Kathleen Sebelius and Dr. Margaret Humber, who was Secretary Sebelius. How worried are you about the level of response right now in the context of the ability to adjust in time to get our kids back in school, at least in most places?
Well, Chris, I don't think there's a parent in this country or a teacher who isn't anxious to reconnect inside a classroom. But parents and teachers and school personnel and superintendents want the safety and security of all the individuals who go into school to be paramount. That's step one. And we have disease now rising, not flatline, not going down, but rising in 35 states around the country. We have death rates that are ticking back up. We have hospitalizations that are, as you say, on the increase. So this virus is out of control in many parts of the country. We're running out of hospital beds. We don't have PPE. And we have the United States Senate who is stuck, who refuses to bring forward the bill that cities and states need. We need extra help in schools to put kids back, more personnel, not less. We need more cleaning crews. We need more space. We need to look district by district, and we need some very clear guidance and guidelines about what happens, where the PPE will be, what the cleaning needs to be, how you get kids safely to school, if you can throw them on a school bus, how you feed kids in school. None of that is happening at a national level. What we have is a president and the Secretary of Education, shockingly,